adorable museum visitors. So they're going to help us understand what's going on this slide. So the Hubble Space Telescope can see more light than we can see. We see visible light. So I want you each to stand, come over here. All right, so let's say this wavelength represents visible light. This is what we're stuck with. This has served our evolutionary purposes. It's worked for humans long enough. But since we're a very curious species, we invented things like the Hubble Space Telescope that could see more light than just visible light. Yes, like ultraviolet light. So, can you show us a shorter wavelength, a UV wavelength, by moving closer together? So you see the wavelength getting shorter. The Hubble Space Telescope can see UV light that we can't see. And now I want you to show us infrared. So that's a longer wavelength than our eyes. So you can keep going. Keep going. Be careful on the stairs. And you can come all over here. Very good. Yeah, if we were to show all the way to radio waves, you would be off the ship at the next pier. But we don't have time for that. So we're going to stick with infrared visible UV. So with all this combined, that's how we get the images that we see in the exhibit here. And does anyone know of any other type of energy that also travels in a wave? Is anyone raising their hand? Yeah. Gamma rays, yeah, gamma rays, but I heard it over here. Yeah, sound. So you can think of longer wavelengths as very low sounds. And you can think of shorter wavelengths as very high sounds. So there's a range that we can hear, and there's a range of light that we can see. So let's give our slinky meisters a round of applause. Yeah.